Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part five of solving nonlinear systems of equations, and we're going to solve this system using both the substitution and the graphing method. So here's our first problem. Solve the system. We only want real solutions. So we could use the graphing method. And if you use the graphing method, notice we have a circle and a parabola. So that's one way of doing it. It's not always obvious where they intersect, so I'm going to go ahead and go with substitution or elimination. So you might see, oh, this is already solved for y. Y equals x squared minus 5. And you can use that substitution, but notice if you plugged in x squared minus 5 in for y here, you're going to have to square this binomial. So I'm going to see if maybe there's another way of doing this. How about if I solve for x squared and I can plug that in for this other x squared? So I'm going to try that. There are many ways you could use substitution. So it depends how you want to do it. So let's see, if I solve for x squared, notice if I add 5 to both sides, I'll get y plus 5 equals x squared. So I want to substitute y plus 5 right in for my x squared. You don't actually have to go all the way down and solve for x, because in this equation up here, I can just put in the x squared as it already is. Later, we'll go back and figure out, all of the values in the order pairs. So we're going to plug in y plus 5 into this equation. So we have x squared plus y squared equals 25, and we're going to plug in for my x squared this y plus 5. So that's what I'm replacing the x squared with, and I have plus y squared equals 25. So I end up with a quadratic. And so to solve a quadratic, you set it equal to 0 and factor. So we have y squared plus y. And let's see, if we subtract 25 from both sides, 5 minus 25 is minus 20 equals 0. Which isn't too hard to factor. We have y plus 5 and y minus 4. So y plus 5 equals 0, or y minus 4 equals 0 gives us a solution for y of either negative 5 or 4. So now I've got to figure out what value of x goes with each of these. All right, so keep in mind that we know that x squared equals y plus 5. So now I'm going to plug in what I know y is, okay, into this equation up here. All right, so we're going to go down a little bit. We know that x squared equals y plus 5, right? So we're going to back substitute. We're going to plug in our negative 5 for y. So we have x squared equals, and we're going to replace y, right? We're going to replace this y with that negative 5 right there. So I've got negative 5 plus 5. So x squared is 0. And then how do we solve that? We take the square roots of both sides. And usually you put plus or minus, but of course, a minus sign in front of a 0 is the same as 0. So x is 0. So what does that mean? When y is negative 5, I got that x was 0. So one of my solutions will be 0, negative 5. So let's go up here. We've got one of our solutions up here is going to be 0, negative 5. We'll just kind of keep track of that up there in red. Okay, now let's do the same thing. We're going to plug in 4 for y into this equation where we did the substitution. Oops, that's supposed to be equal. And now we're going to plug in the 4, right, in place of the y. So we have x squared equals 4 plus 5. So x squared is 9. So x equals plus or minus 3 when you take the square roots of both sides. So when y is 4, there's two possibilities for x. This gives us two ordered pairs, right? It's going to give us the ordered pair 3, 4, and it's also going to give us the ordered pair negative 3, 4. And I'm going to go ahead and put this ordered pair right here too. We had 0, negative 5. So those look to be our three ordered pairs for this problem. And of course we want to check, because that's the only way you know for sure we got the right answer. Sometimes you might get extraneous reads, or you make some sort of arithmetic or algebraic mistake along the way, and you really want to make sure that whatever you get for your solutions makes the original equations both true. So we're going to check all three of these solutions. So we have our original system right here, okay? And we think this is the solution, these three ordered pairs, 0, negative 5, 3, 4, and negative 3, 4. So we need to check each solution in both of the equations. Now, you should be able to put the video on pause and try this on your own and find out if they're indeed solutions. So let's do the first one. So we're going to put in 0 for x, so that's 0 squared. We're going to put in negative 5 for y. So 0 plus 25, which is 25. I've got 25 on both sides, so that's a solution. Now we'll go down and make sure 0, negative 5 is also a solution in the other equation. So we're putting in negative 5 for y, and we're putting in 0 for x. And I get negative 5 on both sides. So I shouldn't have checked this off yet until I check both of them, but yes, it's a solution. All right, let's check 3, 4. Put in 3 for x, 4 for y, get 9 plus 16 is 25. Have 25 on the other side, so that checks. Going to put in 4 for y, 3 for x. So the right hand side, 9 minus 5 is also 4. So 3, 4 checked in both equations. Last one, we're going to plug in negative 3 for x. So we put negative 3 squared plus 4 squared, and negative 3 quantity squared is negative 3 times negative 3, so that's 9 plus 16, or 25. 25 on both sides. And the last check here, we're going to put in 4 for y, put in negative 3 squared for x, and I get 4 on both sides, so this checks as well. So that tells me that it looks like those are the only points of intersection. Now remember, we could have done this by graphing, and now that I see that when I did it using algebra, in other words, I used substitution, my order pairs don't look that tricky. If there were like fractions in there, that would be hard to tell by graphing. So let's go ahead and just graph these two and see if it looks, see if that the points of intersection really are these three order pairs. All right, so we've got these two equations. The first one, x squared plus y squared equals 25, which is a circle with center 0, 0, radius 5, and I've drawn that circle. I'm sketching it, so this is not perfect. The other one is a parabola that goes up with a vertex point of 0, negative 5, which is right down here. And like I said, I'm just sort of sketching it, and so the question is, does it look like it's going through those ordered pairs? And actually, yeah, it does. The only way you know for sure is if you graph perfectly, and that's why you want to check your answer algebraically anyway. So these are the points of intersection, which if you had a very careful graph, you would see that's right where the intersection points are. Even though I've done a slightly rough sketch, you're not really seeing exactly where it goes through the x-axis, etc., this parabola, but this is just sort of verify that our solution also makes sense graphically. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.